In an earlier video, we talked about putting deep joists in for for the floor for a second story, and I briefly talked about using herringbone strutting to stop the joist from twisting or rolling over. So in this video, I just want to show you how you can quickly work out what length they need to be and work out the angle that you actually need to cut them, so that it's a little bit quicker than just trying to measure it and sort of guess. So obviously, hopefully when you set your joists out, you got them, or the majority of them, the same spacing apart, but inevitably you'll end up with some different spacings for your joists. So this process will need to be repeated for every spacing that you have. So what you do is take a piece of your joist material, or you can just measure it. Mark that onto your joists, like that such, and then we need to deduct generally about 12 mil on each edge, just so we don't have any chance of the struts sticking up above our joists. So we'll put our reduction in 12 mil on each, 24 mil overall. So that becomes the new width of our, well, the width of our herringbone strutting, if you like. Once we know that, then it's a really simple process. All we do is just sit the piece of herringbone strutting so that this side is on the bottom and the other side is just touching the top of the other side, is just touching the line there. And then we can just draw two lines up underneath, line there, take that down. So we've got our two marks, cut those. And that will give us our bevel and our length for our herringbone strut. And then obviously, we repeat that or cut the same length again. And that'll give us the one the opposite way. As I said, that exercise needs to be repeated wherever you have a different width of spacing. But that will be a lot quicker than trying to measure it in and guess what the actual bevel and the length is. So that'll make cutting your herringbone struts in a little bit quicker.